Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and for this week's vlog, well not this week, but for today's video, I decided that I'd do some Christmas baking. And if you've been subscribed to my channel, you know that this year I'm attempting to do Vlogmas. I am nervous, but I'm also super excited because A, I've never done this before, but B, I'm also trying to work on my consistency with uploading videos, so we're just gonna see how this works. I'm not gonna promise that I'll be able to upload for all these next days to come, but I am really truly gonna try my best. But yeah, for today's video I said that I'd switch it up, and instead of doing a traditional baking video where you like make cookies, I decided that we'd make some donuts for Christmas. So if you guys really like these types of videos, don't forget to give them a thumbs up, and also don't forget to click the subscribe button if you want to see more of my videos, and so you can stay up to date every single time I upload, because I'm going to be uploading a lot this month. But without further ado, let's just get into it. Okay, so basically I have all the ingredients measured out here, and I'm going to, like, this isn't gonna really be like a tutorial type of video. It's gonna kind of be like a chit chat video where I'll just be baking and I'll be talking to you guys. And I will have the actual recipe linked down below for you guys to follow along with me. So yeah, so in the bowl it said to combine all your dry ingredients. So everything that I measured for the dry ingredients was 3 cups of all-purpose flour, 1 tablespoon of baking powder, 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda. I added in my nutmeg, and then I added in my salt. And then in this bowl I have my sugar, and then I have my 1 egg in here, and then I also have my oil in here, and then last but not least, my vanilla. So the first steps are to whisk this mixture together, so we're gonna do that. Okay, so next, once we're done combining in our dry mixtures together, we're gonna mix our wet mixtures together, which is the sugar, the eggs, and then the canola oil. Not the canola oil, butter. I don't have any butter, so I'm just using canola oil, so let's just cross our fingers and hope for the best. And we're gonna mix them together using an electric beater, so I'm gonna go get my electric beater and then I'll be right back. Okay, so now we just whipped the wet ingredients, so the sugar, the vanilla, and the eggs. And now we're gonna mix the wet ingredients with the dry ingredients, and then we're gonna slowly add the milk in. And then I'm just gonna be answering some more questions because I literally don't know what to talk about, and I just don't want this video to be made up of time lapses. So yeah, let's get started. Start with the questions. Come on. Sorry.
What was the last funny video you saw?
Last funny video I saw. I remember there was this, okay, so for those of you who don't know, there was a new movie that recently came out called Sierra Burgess is a Loser, and I've watched the movie, and I mean, like, I thought it was, like, what I expected of it was a little different, because, I mean, the storyline for the movie is really controversial and stuff like that, and I don't really think there's anything left to say because people have already said everything, and I'd just be repeating what they'd say, what they've said. But I was watching the video, and it was really funny because it was pointing out all the things that were wrong in the movie and just all the weird things, and it was just a really funny video. So yeah, what's the next question?
What do you do to get rid of stress?
What do I do to get rid of stress? Sometimes I either just step away from what I'm doing, or if I am stressed, I like to exercise, or I just like to do something that's completely opposite of what's stressing me out. Like, I'll either go on Netflix and watch, I don't know, a TV show, I'll go on YouTube, or I'll just like go downstairs and like talk to my family, or I'll just talk to somebody about it and see if there are ways that I can get help if I'm ever stressed.
What's something you're obsessed with?
Obsessed with at the moment? I've literally been obsessed with these books. They're from the Lion Game series by Sarah Shepard. I've been reading these books for the longest time, and I'm just obsessed with the book series. It is amazing. I'm currently on the last book in the series because there's 6. I'm on number 6, and I'm currently trying really hard to finish reading it within the next week or so. But all I'm gonna say is the books are amazing. You guys really, really, really need to check them out. You'll thank me later when you read them. So yeah.
Who's your favorite entertainer?
Entertainer? You mean like musician or like
comedian, musician, actor, or etc.
Okay, favorite comedian? I don't have a favorite comedian. Actor? I don't have a favorite actor. Favorite musician? Shawn Mendes is my favorite musician, hands down.
What's your favorite way to waste time?
I like wasting time on Instagram, or I either like wasting time on Netflix or YouTube. Those are my ways. That's how I waste my time, pretty much.
What are you gonna do this weekend?
Film this. That's what I'm doing right now. I'm filming, preparing for Vlogmas.
What was the last time you worked incredibly hard?
Probably when I was like studying for my last math test. I worked really hard for that, or on that.
Are you very active, or do you prefer to relax in your free time?
I'm pretty active, I guess I could say, because I really do like playing sports. I like playing soccer. I like playing basketball as well. I'm not the best at basketball, but I still really do enjoy playing it, so yeah.
What's the best or worst thing about your work/school?
Worst thing about school? The homework. Like, seriously, they give you an absurd amount of homework. Like, why? Like, why? Like, seriously, like, the worst thing about school is honestly the homework and the exams, too. Like, oh my goodness, you have no clue how stressed I get during exam season, but yeah. Okay, so we just finished mixing together all the ingredients. You should have a ball of dough like this, and I'm gonna knead it a bit more off camera, and then I'll be back on when I'm done, and I'll show you guys what it should look like. Okay, so after you've mixed your dough together, you're going to take it out of the bowl, and then you're gonna put it on a nice floured surface along with your rolling pin. You're gonna make sure your rolling pin is nicely covered in flour, and then you're going to take some cookie cutters. I found these festive ones laying around in my cupboard, and I decided that I'd use them because it's the perfect occasion for making Christmas donuts, you know what I'm saying? So now we're just gonna continue with the rest of the video. Yeah.
If you opened a business, what kind of business would it be?
Oh, if I opened a business, I actually really do want to go into business when I finish high school, and I'd really want to do something along with like video editing and videos. I'd also want to do something along with like fashion, or even start like my own clothing line. I'd really want to do something like that. Okay, so I've had my oil on the stove and it's been heating up, and it's very, 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 very important for you to be really careful during these steps because we are working with oil and you can get yourself burnt and you just don't want to hurt yourself at all. So if you don't really know what to do, I recommend that you have a parent watch you, or even if you do know what you're doing, just still have a parent there to watch you in case something goes wrong. So basically, I'm just going to take my donut, it's like this, and then I'm going to take one of these things, and then I'm just going to gently, put the donut in there, and then yeah. Or if you want, you can put it in using your fingers, but you just have to be like really careful that your fingers actually don't touch the oil. And it's on medium heat right now, and we're gonna turn them over once they turn brown. we are finally done making the donuts. I have them here on a plate. They look delicious. They look amazing. I'm definitely going to do a close-up on these donuts because they deserve to be shown off. Now, these don't look like the most festive Christmas donuts, but they are in the shape of, like, Christmas shapes. Like, we have a snowman here. We also have... No, not a snowman. We have a Christmas tree right here, and we also have a gingerbread man right here. These aren't necessarily Christmas colors, but you can customize them to look any way your heart desires. But I really hope you guys did enjoy this video. I'm definitely going to be doing a taste test after this. But if you guys want to see more of my videos, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. And also don't forget to click the subscribe button down below and the bell beside it, because you'll be notified every single time I upload. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye!